welcome back to my channel. Today I have another part of my Disney series with my friends. I think I'm just gonna start calling it Disney series with friends. And for today's video, we are going to be jumping into the beautiful Belle bundle is what I'm going to be using for my Belle look. This is the Beauty and the Beast bundle. So I have the compact and the lip product. The Belle compact is called Enchanted Mirror and it is a blush. So it is a really pretty blush. So I'm definitely going to be using that today for this look. But we are going to be doing Belle and then our Gaston. They are all still inspired looks. And I hope you guys are enjoying this series so far. Today is going to be in a collaboration with Anna, Miss Bennett again. So yeah, I'm really excited. Make sure you guys jump over and show her some love too on her looks. She absolutely killed it with our Tangled inspired looks. She did such an incredible job. We were kind of doing almost like the same sort of looks, so it was like really cool to see that we had a lot of the same ideas. But I'm having so much fun with this series, and all of the people in this series that you guys will see are all super talented and just crazy good at inspired looks. So I mean, I really have some competition here. But yeah, make sure you guys jump over to Anna's video after this one so you guys can see her Belle inspired look and her Gaston look. Let's go ahead and jump into it. I'm also going to be going back into the Midnight Masquerade palette with Belle's look, and then we'll switch it up with Gaston's. I had a little bit of a hard time with Gaston last time because I'm just like, I think out of all characters, he's just like a little boring to me. So I guess we're just going to go for like some type of red eye. We'll just go out off of his shirt. But for Belle, we have Mrs. Potts, which is a gold, and we also have Gaston, which is a red too. So I may incorporate maybe both of those two together. I really like the gold because it kind of like her yellow gold dress. So that's really pretty. I may run a little bit of Gaston, the red, along my lower lash line for my Belle look. And then maybe I'll use this red for my Gaston look as well. And maybe just make it more like fiery, blown out. But we'll just see. I'm going to actually grab another palette. I'm also going to be taking my ColourPop Disney collection, the last Disney princess, just because I honestly need just neutral shades. And this is such a neutral palette that this is what I'm going to be using. So I'm going to be dipping into, I'm going to do Grumpy because it's kind of like a pinky transition, like a pinky brown almost. So I'm going to take a blender brush and just start blending this shade into my crease. So halfway through blending this in my crease, I decided to just go for a halo with the gold. So I'm now taking that same Grumpy shade and I'm just like packing it in that inner corner part just to form the halo. I like this shade because it's very like light, flirty, and not too intense. And that way we won't draw like too much from the gold. Like the gold will be like the main statement of this look, which I think would be really pretty. So I'm just gonna stick with this one and then that gold for now, and we'll just see like how it does. I still wanna do the red along the lower lash line, but I think it'll be really pretty. I am gonna take Prince Charming from this palette, which is like a metallic white, and I'm going to put this on my brow bone and very, very inner corner. Then I'm going to take a little bit more of Grumpy to just kind of blend all of that out. And then going into the Midnight Masquerade, I'm ready to jump into the gold. I'm going to be using my finger since it is a metallic, and I'm going to just take that. It's the shade Mrs. Potts, but it is definitely like a yellow gold, and this is going to be the halo. The shade is super, super pigmented. I'm gonna go back into Grumpy to just kind of blend around it. Kind of evening them up a little bit more. I feel like it's very subtle, but I like that. I feel like Belle, when it comes to like makeup, I feel like it would just be a really subtle look. But we will definitely add a little something extra with having the red shade on the lower lash line. So I went ahead and applied the Enchanted Mirror Blush. It is like a really pretty soft pink shade. It is beautiful, such a flattering color. And then I went into the Super Shop Cheek from the last Disney Princess collection in the shade A Smile and a Song. It's a light champagne gold color. I thought it would be perfect for Belle's look. And then I ran a little bit of Gaston shade along my lower lash line. I feel like it pulls the look together really nicely. I went ahead and did mascara and setting spray and all that too, so we are ready to dive into the lip product. This is another one of the Luxe Liquid Lips, and it's the shade Beast. I'm gonna go ahead and apply this. I feel like it's gonna be a nice shade. I feel like all these shades have been so flattering so far. Yeah, it is such a pretty shade. It's almost like a deep nude, but it does have like a pinky hue to it as well. I feel like all of them have kind of been like these nice, like warm tone, like your lips but better, and then they just get a little deeper from there. But yeah, this is the shade Beast. I went ahead and threw my hair up in a little bit of a bun. It's a messy one, but this is as good as it's gonna get. But this is my completed Belle inspired look. I really like it. I feel like the gold is kind of more like a, you don't really see it as well unless I like close my eyes. So it's kind of like a peekaboo moment almost. But I really do like it. I feel like it all pulls together, and I really like the Gaston shade lightly underneath the lower lash line. I do think I want to go a little bit more heavy with the red for Gaston and that look. If you guys want to see that look, then just keep on watching. My hair is doing some funny things today, but we are going to be diving into the Gaston look. Like I said, after my Belle look, I'm just going to be using this Gaston shade today, and I really just want to like blow it out and make it dramatic. So that's what we're going to be doing. I'm going to first take Pip, which is this shade right here, just kind of start like a lighter transition maybe. I feel like this might just be pointless because we're just going to be going over it, but just to kind of get something worked out. Thinking about maybe winging it out a little bit. I know I look a little crazy. This eye with allergies has been so bad. You guys will probably like be able to tell in some of my videos just like how bloodshot and stuff it is. Oh, it's been driving me insane with allergies. And then for highlight today, I want to take, let's just go for Spinning Wheel in this palette, that like pinky white. I'm gonna put a little bit of that in the inner corner and brow bone. Kind of sloppily because we're gonna blend by it. I feel like the older I get, I'm like more and more like Belle. I'm like a bookworm, you know, I like to go places and like, let me rephrase that. I don't like getting out in the public, but if it's like a good like exploring type of situation, I'm down. Like I get so excited to just kind of like get out, get some fresh air. But I'm definitely like a bookworm and kind of a loner. I keep to myself a lot. Now for Gaston, we're gonna go into that red Gaston shade. I loved this for the lower lash line. I'm gonna zoom you guys up. I love this for the lash line on Belle though, so I'm excited to like really go there with this shade today. Yeah, I really like that, and I like how it's blended into that Pip shade. for like a more like warm tone look. I think I'm gonna add a wing liner moment to this. Maybe a little bit of it underneath my lower lash line. I think Gaston's look's gonna be pretty simple. So for bronzer and highlight today, I went into my Pure Sculptor palette and used those shades right there. For blush, I used my ColourPop Exoella Soulmate Blush. You guys know I love that one. I'm going to be running some more of that Gaston shade along my lower lash line. Definitely a little bit darker of a look. For my lips, I'm gonna be using my KKW lipstick. This is the Nude 3. It's a little bit of like a warm nude. So this is my completed Gaston look. Like always, both makeup looks will be down below in the description box so you guys can find all the products that I use there, because I know I jump off camera a lot for certain parts, but I really like how this turned out. I feel like it's a lot more of a muted purple, red, than my last Gaston look that I did in my last time that I did this series. I went for like a wing liner red, so I definitely wanted to change it up this time, but I really do love this deeper red. It's giving me like vampy feels. I love this, and I feel like it's like a really pretty like fall time look, but I definitely get Gaston inspo from this. And I kind of liked a little bit of a twist, making it a little bit darker with the liner. Making it more like a villain, because he is a villain. So I hope you guys enjoyed my looks. Let me know down below, did you guys like the Belle look or the Gaston look better? And yeah, go make sure you go check out Anna's looks and see what she created for her Belle and Gaston inspired looks. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video.